Now, friends, we come to the 34th chapter, and we begin here with the reign of Josiah and the last revival that took place before the captivity. And it's at the end of the line, and it's amazing that it did take place. It's after the reign of Manasseh and the reign of Amon, and you've got two men there that really plunge that nation into idolatry and sin. You'd think there's no hope at all, but there's always hope. And this, again, is another case of where, in matters of revival, the Holy Spirit is sovereign. And I do not know whether we'll have a revival in our day or not. I do not preclude the possibility for the very simple reason that here was a time when I would have said that they couldn't have had revival, and humanly speaking, they couldn't. But the Spirit of God is sovereign, and God moved in. God could move in today, and there's nothing in the Word of God that would preclude that possibility, and we need to recognize that. There are those today that feel like, one man said to me, the trouble with you men that believe in prophecy and emphasize the terrible days that are coming, why you have no place for revival. Well, I think we do. I just feel like the others don't have any place for revival at all. And the reason I say that is because they're trying to work it up themselves. My friend, you can't work it up or pray it down. The Spirit of God is sovereign. And our prayer ought to be today, Lord, put me in the will of God. And as we said the other day, let's make sure our own lives are right before God. And this idea that we're going to get God to do something and nothing's going to happen to us. We need to straighten our own lives out before God. And there are a lot of questions we need to ask ourselves. Am I honest? Am I truthful? Am I pure? What about it? No use you talking about revival and me talking about revival, long as we're actually not getting right in our own hearts before God. We need to be right, and then we can look to the Spirit of God in a sovereign way and ask Him to move according to His will.